Friday Night Baseball now from Fenway Park here in Boston. Tonight we begin the homestand with the first of four between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Boston Red Sox. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. Rick Porcello, a right-hander from the Garden State of New Jersey, gets the ball here. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, this will be his second start of the season. In his first start, he already got himself in the win column. He'll be looking to add to that here.
Troy Tulowitzki heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some evening baseball.
Shortstop, number 42.
First pitch tonight is looked at for strike one as we get underway at 7:11 p.m. Eric Karros, this Red Sox ball club entering play here tonight. They're coming off another victory last time out, and now they're winners of eight of their last nine ball games.
And the thing about baseball is that each new day brings a new opportunity. So we'll see if these guys are up to the task here.
And that'll manage to hop over the wall. He'll be at second to start the game on a ground rule double. And that's in there, base hit. Tulowitzki will take the turn and head for home. And he is in there. Josh Donaldson will get his first shot at it here. One for four with a double in the ball game last night. Now started to go down after it, and he couldn't hold back. It's strike one. Now a fastball that's taken close that time, but it's one and one. Skied into very shallow right. Castillo is under it. Makes the play, one away. With that, a look at John Gibbons' lineup for the visiting Blue Jays. What's the key for them to win this series opener, Steve?
Well, guys, this is a power-heavy lineup. You need to stay patient and get balls up in the zone that they can drive.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
Right back, same pitch, also knee-high. He wasn't buying that one either. He's going to have to do something now. He's down two strikes.
And with a quick breather here, take a look at the Red Sox on defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, this defense is really anchored up the middle, and most specifically, the guy over at second base. He turns the double play as well as anybody in the game, has a lot of range, and really takes away a lot of hits from the other team.
That's on the corner to put him behind now, 1-2.
Well, nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
In the dirt here. And he is safe at second, and the wild pitch here could prove costly with two away. Still 2-2. Very weakly on the ground. Boy, and slow out of the box that time as he's tagged out quickly. A run on two hits here for Toronto. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. It's the Blue Jays 1 and the Red Sox nothing. Marcus Stroman will be on the mound for the series opener. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, he's got a career ERA of just under 3.5. He's thrown some great ball games in his career. He's thrown some real clunkers. Hopefully, for his sake, he throws well in this one.
Now a swing and a drive down the line. This has the height, and it's a fair ball over the monster for a home run. So it's a solo home run to lead off the bottom of the first. Sixth home run on the season for him. And with it, the Red Sox have tied it at one.
And this is one of those guys that we consider to be part of that new breed of leadoff hitter. You know, it used to be that your leadoff guy was a guy that might hit three or four home runs a year. But nowadays, managers are realizing, hey, my leadoff guy is going to get more at-bats than anyone else in my lineup over the course of the season. So why not put a better hitter up there rather than just a punch and Judy guy? And that certainly worked out for him right here.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. And now a curveball that bounces up to the plate. It's 1-1. EK, as the Jays take the field here tonight, they've been in a nice little groove, winning three of their last four games.
Yeah, and they were home for just a short time before heading right back out on the road again. So it's been a lot of packing and unpacking recently. That's the life of a big league ball player.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. Takes this the other way to right. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see, and he was right on that one.
David Ortiz will get his first opportunity now. 0 for 4 in Wednesday's ball game. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes.
Well, you know, three straight hits are bad enough, but now he's making things even worse by falling behind the next guy.
Fastball misses away here. It's 2-0.
He's still got a couple pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. You got to take a step back, take a deep breath, and get back in the zone.
3-0 now. The alarm bells are ringing now.
They're getting louder and louder, too.
A throw behind the runner at second, and he's back standing. First and second here with nobody out. Oh, high, deep. That is a moonshot, folks. A long home run. So it's a three-run shot for David Ortiz. 7 home runs for him on the year now. And with it, the Red Sox have taken a 4-1 lead.
That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Here's the left fielder, Hanley Ramirez. He'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that's through for a hit.
And it may be time to go to yellow alert now. That's 5 straight hits off him here in the very first inning. He still hasn't gotten an out yet. Looks like they're just sitting back and teeing off on him.
On the ground to second base, this could be 2. Tulowitzki for 1. On to first, and the Pandas retired. It's a double play. Now a chance here from Fenway to take a look at John Farrell's starting lineup card. Steve, what's the key for him here tonight?
Well, I think you need to take advantage of balls up in the zone, and you could probably say that almost every day, but this is a great hitter's park. You get something to drive, they end up in the seats here.
Ruzne Castillo will stand in, and he is off to a dreadful start at the plate as he has not hit the ball well in April. Stroman's ready. Here comes the first pitch. This is popped high in the air toward the right side of the infield. Colabello is there, and he puts it away to stop the bleed. Chris Colabello will stand in, and that average has to be a source of pride for him early on. He's got it up over 350 to start the new season. Second inning starts with a fastball that misses. It's 1-0. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1.
Oh, a very hittable pitch, too. That's a middle-of-the-plate fastball, and he's not going to get away with too many of those tonight.
Porcello's ready, looking to put him away here on a ball and 2 strikes. Hit to third. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Dominic Brown will stand in now. He homered in the ballgame last night.
Yeah, that was a good one for him, and he needed it because, as you can see, his batting average on the year ain't pretty.
Swihart has a play, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Batting eighth, second baseman, Devin Travis.
Devin Travis into the box here in the top of the second, looking to keep this inning going. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
Hit hard to short. Oh, and leaping ability, not a strength of Big Poppy. It's over his head.
Just an airmail shot that time. The pickup's good, but this ball just sails straight over his head at first base. Good effort to try and go up and get it, but this is well out of his reach.
Standing in now, Tony Sanchez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. A runner on first with two away. That changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now.
Well, I just don't think he was expecting that one, and it was the perfect time to just take a little off.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Jackie Bradley Jr. will dig in now, and he's got to be wondering when his bat's going to make the trip north from spring training, as he has really struggled in the early going. High and deep to left center field. Ranging back is Pilar, but he can't get it as it's off the wall. And he'll get in there standing up with a leadoff double. Blake Swihart will stand in now with the runner at second following the leadoff double.
Yep, more hot water here to start the inning, and it's right back into that stretch again. And this is starting to become a theme for him.
First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. For Bradley, that's his first double of the year here on the young campaign. Chased out of the zone there, and he's down two strikes.
And this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2.
And I think that might have been a little bit of a purpose pitch right there up in the zone. Now I think he's going to come back down with something to try to get that strikeout.
And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. And with that, let's give you a look at the defensive alignment for the Blue Jays. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, the center fielder in this one, as good as anybody out there in the field. Has a lot of speed, can cover a lot of ground, and most importantly, he's very reliable.
Mookie Betts will stand in to try to duplicate his first at-bat, where he homered to open the inning.
That really got this ball club going. When your leadoff guy gets on like that, kind of just fuels the momentum. Everybody starts to hit.
And a step off, and now the runner's trying for third. And he is out, retreating to second as they slap the tag on him.
And this is a helpless feeling as a runner. I mean, he's trying to be aggressive, but gets a little too over-anxious, and they step off and nail him.
First pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. The 0-1 pitch. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. A lot of balls down in the zone in the last inning or so.
And I think that's in response to getting bit by those two home run balls. He might be a little leery of challenging guys right now, and I don't blame him. Keep it down there.
Two out, nobody on. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
I'll say this. He wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
High and deep to right center field. Pilar racing back. Still going back. But he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. Around second, he'll try for third. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. But no, he'll put on the brakes and head back to third.
Now batting. It's a real good effort out there in center field. I didn't think he was going to have much of a chance to track this down, but he nearly comes up with it as it hits off the wall. And then once this kicks away from him, winds up getting played into a triple.
Here's the second baseman now, Dustin Pedroia, as he swings at the first pitch and lifts a fly ball out to left field. Brown is there, and he puts this one away. Red Sox leave one as they hold on to a 4-1 lead.
Shortstop, Troy Tulowitzki.
Troy Tulowitzki is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. And Tulowitzki can't come up with that one as he falls behind 0-2 now. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one. Kevin Villar stands in following an RBI single his first time through. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
And at least he's taken a few pitches here. That's more than the rest of these guys can say.
That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now. Chops it foul at home plate as the count moves to 2-2 now. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, so much for your number one and two guys being your table setters. I mean, they're both gone now on back-to-back strikeouts.
Donaldson.
Josh Donaldson stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
And opposite field as he lines this down the line in right. And this will find the wall down there near Pesky's pole. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
How about it?
Edwin Encarnacion will get an opportunity here in a run-scoring spot now following the two-out double. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. Well, we'll give you a look there at the graphic. He's at second with his Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Danger averted following the two-out double. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Xander Bogaerts will step in to lead things off here for the Red Sox. Big Poppy on deck to follow.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
Out in front of it, strike one. Stroman looks in, coming at him with the 0-1. Heading out towards shallow right, Bautista moves over, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting, first baseman.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And set to stand in the first baseman here, David Ortiz. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. In tight at 93, ball one.
Even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
Not close. It's 2-0. Two and one after the foul ball there. Two balls and a strike. Here it is. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Throw on to first will be there in plenty of time as the Ortiz shift works again. And there are two away now. Stepping in, Hanley Ramirez. He reached on a single in his first try. Bat explodes as this has popped up. And he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, Jose Bautista, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. On the ground and right at the shifted infielders. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. Settling in now, Chris Colabello. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And you'd think, for as hot as this guy's been over the last few games, they might be treading carefully. They're coming right after him, and now they've got him in an 0-2 hole.
Bases are empty, one man out. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it, 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Throw over to Ortiz, gets him, two down.
How about it? Left fielder, Dominic Brown.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Dominic Brown. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, his swing definitely broke down a little bit last time. He got way underneath the ball. It'll be interesting to see if he can make that adjustment and stay on top of the ball here.
And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Oh, and he's finding his groove out there now. It's 0-2.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
Porcello gets the sign. Here it is on 0-2. Chop foul at the plate and we'll do it again. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Got him swinging and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. They trail it 4-1. Pablo Sandoval is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
For the Red Sox, third baseman, Pablo Sandoval.
First offering on its way. Grounded to the right. Gravis fields it cleanly. A quick out number one.
Now batting, right fielder, Rusney Castillo.
Rusney Castillo in now, popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fastball. That top hand kind of dragged through the zone, which caused the bat head to drop a little bit.
The windup and the 0-1. That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Four runs, seven hits, and one error on the Boston line score. That's in there on the outer half, 1-2 now.
And I think now you're starting to get the sense that he's put that first inning behind him, and he looks a lot more comfortable out there now.
Dribbled up the line. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
Left fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Jackie Bradley Jr. walks into the box, reached base with a double his first time up.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one.
He's thrown a first-pitch strike to around 90% of the batters he's faced, and yet he's getting lit up. I mean, you got to throw first-pitch strikes, but they can't be hittable.
Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Bradley with wheels headed for second. And he's not stopping. He wants three. The relay throw, but he is in there with a triple.
First triple for him on the young season. And you could tell he had it on his mind from the start that it was going to be three bases.
And now the Blue Jays get a left-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. First pitch coming. Here it is. Ripped on the ground to first. And they'll escape danger here after the two-out triple as the inning is over. Leading off the inning, Devin Travis. And they'll need him to get something going here.
And in a pretty close game so far, they'd love to see this guy get on base so they can get a rally started to get back in this thing.
And here's a ball hit in the air. After it is Castillo. But he won't get there. It falls in. So with the leadoff man reaching base here, let's take a moment to check out this date in baseball history. Digging in, Tony Sanchez. He got called out on strikes his last time through. Chopped weakly to the left. And he's safe at first as he beats this one out by about a half a step. And now there's no happier person in the ballpark. Tony Sanchez has just recorded his first hit as a big leaguer. And as you'd expect would happen, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
You know, Matt, nothing can quite prepare you for this kind of moment. Of course, as a player, you always expect to do well. And in your head, you've got a certain idea of what it's going to feel like. But there's quite a difference between imagining how it's going to feel and then actually getting that first hit.
And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1. It's a swinging bunt up the line. That's a foul ball. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Betts has it in his tracks. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And the run will score on the sacrifice fly as they cut the lead in half. 4-2 now.
Well, nobody's going to confuse this guy with Miguel Cabrera or Chris Davis, but with the runner on third, he doesn't have to hit the ball out of the ballpark. Just has to get one deep enough out there to deliver that run from third. That's nice going.
Fastball called for strike two.
No ball. Two strikes.
Froze him for strike three, and that retires the side. A run on two hits here for Toronto. Home half of the fifth coming up. The Red Sox 4, the Blue Jays 2. Mookie Betts will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been stuck in.
Yeah, and after that first inning, it's been all zero since. And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
Stroman gets the sign. Here's the first pitch. Into the seats, 0-1. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch, and it's 0-2. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball. A great pitch with two strikes. You start it in the zone and then let it work out and see if he'll chase.
And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out.
Now batting.
Oh, this one could have been trouble. But that's a nice play behind the plate to clear himself of the runner and then make a good throw on to first base to get the put out.
Into the windup and the pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Pilar will wait on it. And he's got it for out number two.
Now batting.
Xander Bogaerts will dig in now. A single and a fly out for him in two trips thus far.
And you know, I think he's had a good approach in each of his first two at-bats. He seems to be seeing the ball well and putting some decent swings on it.
Brown going back, but he can't make a play, and it's off the monster. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is... Edwin Encarnacion will get us going for the Jays here as they start their half of the sixth.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat because you know he has big-time power.
Squared that one up just a little late. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take or whether he just got fooled on a changeup and couldn't pull the trigger.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Oh, and they pulled the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
And, you know, he really doesn't have to throw that changeup all that much for it to be an effective pitch. And you can see what his breakdown is so far.
Jose Bautista will stride forward now. He's bounced out a couple of times already here in the ballgame.
Just a little off on his earlier swings, guys. He's got to keep that top hand palm up through contact to keep from rolling over.
He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Yeehaw! That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
And it looks like the scouting report says, work this guy away, and it's been paying off.
Right, and whoever put together that scouting report did a real nice job because this whole team hasn't done much offensively at all.
Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him. Chris Colabello will stand in again. Couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. And here's a fastball called for strike one. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Swihart is under it, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. David Ortiz will get his cuts leading off. David Ortiz will stand in, and as he does, we'll flash you back to the first inning of the ballgame. A 3-run shot had him off and running right out of the gate. Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. Stroman steps into the windup, 1-1 pitch on its way. Fastball not close, and he runs it to 2 balls and a strike.
Well, that's a good thing that pitch was above the strike zone because a few inches lower, and that ball's right in his wheelhouse.
All even at 2-2, here it is. And a good battle brewing as Ortiz lays off. It's full 3-2. Hanley Ramirez waits on deck. Curveball, strike 3 called, and he didn't like it, but there's the first out.
Now batting.
Yeah, a 3-2 count leading off the inning. Is this in the zone? Doesn't look like it from that angle. Maybe he thought it was too close to take, but I think it should be on first base right now.
Here's Hanley Ramirez as he'll go after the first pitch and send a ground ball down to third. In time to first, and there are two away.
Up next for the Red Sox, third baseman, Pablo.
So two are gone in the inning, and we'll get a chance to see the free-swinging Pablo Sandoval. Tapped out in front of home. Sanchez gonna have to hurry. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Red Sox go down 1-2-3, but they still lead this one 4-2. Welcome back to Fenway Park here in the great city of Boston. Red Sox on top in this one as we get set for the seventh, but first here's a look at our game summary to this point. Leading off the inning, Dominic Brown, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. There's Porcello back at it now as he gets ahead of the leadoff man. No balls and a strike.
Well, he started off this way, and he continues on. He's throwing first-pitch strikes to 80% of the batters he's faced, and we're late in this ballgame, and that's why he's on top.
Now batting, second base.
Now in the box, Devin Travis. He singled his last time up. Bouncer down the line, but it gets fouled. Porcello into the windup. 0-1 pitch on its way. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
Yeah, ground ball out to start the seventh. Now an 0-2 count. He's looking sharp as ever.
And he punches out another one. Make it 9 for the ball game. Tony Sanchez steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
Tony Sanchez
sends that one out of play for strike one. Swing and a miss, and he's in control 0-2.
He's getting a lot of outs right now because he's attacking the...
Got him looking, and that'll do it. The inning is over. Blue Jays go down in order. Aaron Loop will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. And some action now in the Toronto bullpen as a right-hander starts to get loose. Ruzne Castillo stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
Yeah, when that's upstairs like that, that's a pitch you gotta leave alone and make him bring something down.
And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
So nice to have a left-handed weapon like this in your bullpen. And he gets a leadoff man here for an important first out.
Here's Jackie Bradley now. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Now the 0-1. Grounded to third. Donaldson's up with it. On to first, and there are two down.
Now batting.
Blake Swihart will dig in for the third time now. He's struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A little bouncer. But that one rolls foul. Oh, and one count and the pitch. Chased a low ball there, and he's quickly down in the count 0-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now. And a check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three, and the inning is over. Troy Tulowitzki will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there, and he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long, and I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on, and that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Kevin Pillar. Comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch. Something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2. And he struck him out. And there's strikeout number 11 in the ballgame. Josh Donaldson will stand in as they're quickly down to their final four outs tonight.
And Matt, they'd like nothing more than to ignite a two-out rally right here. Maybe scratch at least one across before the ninth. Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
Koji Uehara will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. Edwin Encarnacion will stand in now in what could be a real make-or-break situation.
And you think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
And he misses with it, 1-1. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. And no complaint about that one. That's a strike, and it's 1-2. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Uehara pauses. Here's the 1-2. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Line toward the gap in left center, and that'll get down for a base hit. Jose Bautista stands in trying to make it three straight two-out hits. He's got a runner in scoring position at second.
And you know how good hitting can prove contagious in an inning. Let's see if he can keep it rolling.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
The crowd thought they had him, but definitely outside. Not by a whole lot, though.
Chopped in front of home plate. Throw on to first is in time, and the Toronto rally goes for naught as the inning is over. Blue Jays leave a pair. Mookie Betts will get things going for the Red Sox with Dustin Pedroia to follow.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
Swing and a little tapper. That rolls foul for strike one. To third. Donaldson's there. And reined in, one away.
Up next for the Red Sox,
Dustin Pedroia will stand in. He flew out his last time up. First pitch on its way. Now a swing and a miss as they start him out on a pitch well inside for strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Pillar is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Now batting.
Xander Bogaerts ready for another at-bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far.
Yeah, and you can bet he'd love to get himself that third hit. Those are the kind of games that puts a little extra pep in your step.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. This is hit sharply to the left side. Leaps and makes a terrific catch, and with that, the side is retired. Get up there, big fella, and take away a hit at third. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Welcome back to Baseball on the Show from Beantown, Boston, Mass. We're set for the final innings of this one.
Your attention, please.
Now ninth inning safe situation coming up now as they'll entrust Craig Kimbrel with the baseball here as he'll try and close things out. Chris Colabello is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2. And he missed with it. It's 1-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Dominic Brown will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Now a fastball on the inside corner, and he takes a look at strike one. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two. Hit well on the ground to first. And he'll take this on to first, and they're down to their final out, two away.
Devin Travis
is in now as he watches a pitch for ball one. The win would belong to Rick Porcello, barring any late excitement here. Tried to hold back, but this is popped up, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now a swing, and he pops him up, right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate, and no one will get this one.
Well, I've got to think this is a lack of communication right here. I don't know if he heard an, I got it, or what, but this should be an easy pop out. Instead, he doesn't even get leather on it.
Close, but it's not over yet. That's ball two.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking on the final out, so that's a tough pitch to lay off.
And with about 32,000 in the building, they're on their feet now. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller. Tony Sanchez will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Now, you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
A strike, and it's 2-1. Taken, called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight. Two out with the man at first. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
And obviously a walk here would be a big no-no with two outs in the ninth. You cannot put that tying run on base.
And he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Yeah, that's a nice win here for these guys. And now I think, EK, you better hurry up and get to a computer so you can get your taxes in by midnight.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory. So the Red Sox helped out quite a bit by the start turned in by this man, Rick Porcello. Strike opposed, he's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he was really overpowering guys out there. Look at the line score. He winds up with 11 strikeouts, and he definitely was a deciding factor in this one.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian.